Bender Dan Sheeran Show.
Yeah.
Shout out.
We
got some shout outs today.
Who you shouting out to?
We got a some new listeners in the Pittsburgh area. Shout out to Joe Gardner.
Joe.
Bill Harder. Julia Tobias.
Julia.
Ben Roethlisberger. I just threw that one in.
Doesn't
there.
He play for the Chicago White Sox?
Yeah, he's a cleanup hitter for the White Sox.
Cleanup hitter, okay.
About Ben, I don't know. He might be listening.
He could.
Why wouldn't he be? I assume Peyton Manning's listening here in Indianapolis.
Course.
Why wouldn't he be?
Yeah.
I was downtown yesterday walking. You know what that field? Lucas Oil Field. What a name. Lucas Oil Field.
It sounds slickery.
Yeah, it does. All these fields are going corporate.
I guess so.
Lucas Oil. What in the good old days? Lambo hasn't caved into the pressure yet, thank God. Yeah. Has it?
No.
Has Lambo Field become anything?
I have no idea.
Like, Tinker Toy Field or Miracle Whip Arena. Everybody, this corporate stuff's driving me nuts. I don't like it. Let's define free will. I'm really concerned that people are going to think we're saying that we don't have wills.
No, we're not saying that.
We're not saying that.
You know, even the term free will occurs in Scripture.
What? Oh, free will offering.
Free will offering, yeah.
Explain the free will offering and explain why that doesn't undo what we're saying.
Because
what we're saying,
the free will offering in the Hebrew script, it's interesting. What is interesting about the free will offering?
Yeah, tell me.
Is that it was given in light of building the tabernacle, and they were to bring these offerings as a free will offering.
That doesn't explain your defense.
I'm going to finish when I'm shut up.
I'm
for
sorry.
A minute.
Just talk, I apologize.
Why don't you be quiet? You
All
know?
Right, I'll try.
Okay. They were to bring materials to build the tabernacle, but guess where they got the material from? They got it from spoiling the Egyptians. God gave them material. And David later on says, regarding these free will offerings, that it was God who put it in their hearts to do it.
Really?
Yeah.
You got a verse on that. I mean, I'm not asking you to quote, but
you know
it's there, right? Read the whole Old Testament.
You'll find it. While you could talk for a little bit, and I'll look for it.
Okay. Ben Roethlisberger, now, I like the Steelers. No, seriously. The free will offering, it was, we can say that, it was in opposition to an offering where they said you had to give it, right? Am I right about that? A free will offering came from the heart of the people.
Yes.
And a non-free will offering would be give this or else, like the tithe. You have to bring 10%. So that was not a, quote, free will offering. Now, by calling this other, as far as bringing materials, by calling that a free will offering, we are not saying that those people had absolute free will, that they were acting independently of the deity. Don't jump to that horrible conclusion. They were free only in relation to the other people who were told to bring an offering. And it was always God behind it. And Dan has found the verse.
Yeah, here in the First Chronicles 29, it says, "Then the people rejoiced, for they offered willingly."
Willingly.
Right? And because with perfect heart they offered willingly to the Lord, and David the king also rejoiced with great joy. And then later David prays in the same chapter. He says, "We thank thee and praise thy glorious name, but who am I and what is my people that we should be able to offer so willingly after this sort? For all things come of thee, and of thine own have we given thee." So even the free will offerings was not something that came out of them.
Yeah.
And he goes on in this chapter, and he says, "As for me, in the uprightness of mine heart, I have willingly offered all these things, and the people have done it." And it says here, "O Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Israel, our fathers, keep this forever in the imaginations of the thoughts of the heart of thy people, and prepare their heart unto thee." Isn't that interesting? And so David here is recognizing that even this free will offering is something that God put in their hearts to do.
And again, it was only called a free will offering to differentiate it from the offerings that were
required
right. mm-hmm. that you give. And what you just read there is Paul really hammers this truth in Acts 17:25. He's giving his fabled address on Mars Hill, and he says, since he himself, speaking of God, gives to all life and breath and all. I'm going to emphasize the active verb here. I love active verbs. Gives. He gives to all. This sends us back to what happened with Saul on the road to Damascus. God gave him faith. He didn't allow Saul to choose Christ. Saul on the road to Damascus did not choose Jesus Christ, did he?
No.
Did he make a decision to be saved? No. This was in total opposition to what he had in mind, and the grace of God overwhelmed him because God gave to him life. He gave him his life, even when he was a Pharisee.
Right.
He gave him his breath. Every inhalation was a gift of God, and he gave him all. And in case we're missing anything, all. God gives to all life, okay, and breath, and everything else.
That's right.
Gives. Active verb. Gives. And so that is a perfect illustration of what he did to Saul on the road to Damascus.
And you put it this way. We always bring up Hitler, because people always bring up Hitler. Who provided Saul of Tarsus, Paul the Apostle, with the dinner he had that Friday night?
East of Chicago pizza?
God did.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All right, who supplied Hitler the dinner the same night he attacked Poland?
Who brought the food? Who was responsible? I would have to say God, ultimately.
Okay, now, that same night that Paul was eating, who provided the breath when Paul was breathing for life that night?
God.
Okay, that night Hitler invaded Poland, before he sat down in dinner, as he was breathing in and out, who provided him with the breath?
Eva Braun. I mean God.